Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about cracking those knuckles and joints, and is it bad for you? Something we've been told since childhood. Well, I'm going to answer that question, along with many other questions, in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we always look at the evidence. Jacob Levi, my girlfriend can't stand me cracking my knuckles, and I want to know if it's bad for me. Jacob Levi, thank you for your comment. I like this comment very much, which is why I picked it. And I guess you're right, some people really don't like the sound of cracking joints and knuckles, some people really, really dislike it. I have never really minded it, maybe it's because I like to do it now and then, but some people have louder cracks than others. That's an important fact to remember. So let's begin with some science. Firstly, what is that cracking and popping sound that you get in the joints and knuckles? Well, it's basically nitrogen bubbles bursting in our sinoavial fluid. Now, you may be thinking, what on earth is sinoavial fluid? And if you don't know what it is, sinoavial fluid basically helps lubricate our joints. It kind of works in a similar way to engine oil. The sinoavial fluid helps reduce the friction in the joints, and it helps preserve our cartilage. If you're a keen popper, you may have noticed that once you popped or cracked your knuckles, you can't do it again for about 20 minutes. And this is because you're all out of nitrogen bubbles. So those nitrogen bubbles in your sinoavial fluid, they've popped, they've burst, you're all out of it. So you can't do it again until about 20 minutes, which is the approximate time it takes for these nitrogen bubbles to refill again, and then you're able to burst them again. Now, going back to the question from Jacob, is cracking your knuckles bad for you? Because I'm sure a lot of us have been told since childhood, don't do that, you're gonna get arthritis. Don't do that, you're gonna hurt yourself. And the good news is, there has actually been a fair amount of research on this, and I can confirm, cracking your knuckles is unlikely that you're gonna get joint damage, and it's not gonna lead to arthritis. So cracking your joints is unlikely to cause any harm to your fingers, your neck, your leg, your foot, wherever you like to crack throughout the day, it's unlikely to cause any harm. So it's good to know, whether you crack compulsively throughout the day, or you just crack randomly when you're walking or doing something throughout the day. However, please do remember that if you experience any discomfort from cracking those joints, then there could be a pre-existing condition that's getting aggravated by those movements and pressure that you're putting on the joints. So the best advice I can give for that is if you get any kind of discomfort from cracking your joints, please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional so they can examine it and find out what's going on. So Jacob and anyone else watching, I guess the moral of the story is crack away, my friends. And as long as you have no discomfort, there's nothing to worry about because it's unlikely to cause any harm. And Jacob, specifically going back to you, I guess your girlfriend's just gonna have to find a better reason to make you stop. Thank you for the comment, and I hope this information helps anyone who's searching up if cracking your knuckles or joints is bad for you. Now, let's move on to the next comment, sending you all awesome vibes. Hazel Mapetta, thanks for the video. My 11-year-old daughter swallowed her first capsule. Thank you for sharing. Hazel, thank you for sharing this. And congratulations to your daughter for swallowing her first capsule. This is from a video all about how to swallow tablets and capsules. It's based from some studies, and we look at different techniques. A lot of people find it really useful, and it makes me so happy to read comments like this, because swallowing capsules and tablets sometimes can be really difficult. You know, it's like a foreign object that you're swallowing and no one likes it and it tastes horrible. But I'm glad that this video can help people. Sending you awesome vibes. Let's move on to the next comment. Madina Munawara, I cut all sweets and sugars, so bad breath gone. I don't know how to thank you. I had bad breath for the last 6 years, but I didn't know my diet was causing bad breath. Madina, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of Bad Breath video. And yes, I'm very glad I can help you. And sugars, dietary sugars and stuff like that can make bad breath worse. The bacteria love that kind of stuff. They love sugar and they go crazy and they multiply and it causes the bad breath. So I'm really happy I can help you. And you said you don't know how to thank me. By leaving a comment, that is more than enough. And I am so happy that I can help you and help loads of people out there. Thank you for the comment. The Dark Pirate 64. You are literally my hero. I've been listening to your weight loss videos and I'm truly inspired to lose weight. Thank you, Abraham. So far, I've lost 3 kilograms from 69 to 66. The Dark Pirate, this is for you, mate. Well done. I am so happy for you. Thank you for commenting. I am so happy I can inspire you. And you've lost that 3 kilos because you wanted to. You made that decision and you did it. So congratulations. And hopefully you've lost some of that dangerous visceral fat, the stuff that we talk about in the weight loss video. If you haven't seen that video, I will leave a link to it up here. It's all based on a study done on Oxford. And if you do it right, you can lose quite a lot of weight quite easily. So I'd highly recommend you all watch it. But thank you for your comment. This really made me happy. And I'm so happy that I could help you. Smoked salmon. Anytime I actually have health issues, he shows up. The heck, smoked salmon. I got your back, mate. I got your back. That's what I'm there for. If you've got a health issue, Abraham the Pharmacist is there for you. Search him up on YouTube, watch his video, and if he can't help you, he will always direct you to the right person and when to get medical attention. But I'm so happy I can help. You know, that's one of the reasons why I love YouTube so much. You know, it's so accessible. There's so many people around the world watching it. I'm still in awe when I go on my YouTube analytics and I see people watching my videos from all over the world. Thailand, Norway, Denmark, Australia, New Zealand, USA, everywhere around the world they're watching my video. And I'm like, you know, what did I deserve to get all these views? And you know, I guess people are finding the information helpful. And that's one of the reasons why I'm so happy making these videos. And I really do enjoy it. I've always enjoyed making these videos. Since a young age, I've always loved making videos, by the way. But being able to mix my healthcare professional work with YouTube, it really gives me a massive purpose. And yeah, I'm having a very heartfelt moment right now. But yeah, sending you all awesome vibes. Thank you. Mikhail Panin, can you speak Russian? Ya не говорю по-русски. So it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's responding to your comments. If I didn't get back to your comment, if I didn't get back to your question, I am really sorry. We are getting so many comments and questions these days. It's really hard to fit them all into one episode and get back to all of you. So the best advice I can give you all is keep commenting, keep commenting, keep doing it until one day I get back to your comment. Thank you for watching, sending you all awesome vibes. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Now, if you're a keen popper, should I call it that? Mikhail, ya не говорю по-русски. Не говорю. Mate, just go with this, man. It's trying to be Polish, Russian. Ya не говорю по-русски. Ya не говорю по-русски. Я не говорю по-русски. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.